A Guide to Snookers in the World Rules. Sometimes, it's hard to visualize how the written rules should be interpreted. So here you will find some images, courtesy of Steve Camp from Shropshire, which explains how snookers are defined within the world rules. Total snookers. Prior to taking a shot that does not follow a foul, if you cannot hit any part of any ball on, including the black ball if you are on black, by way of a straight line shot, then you are in a total snooker. Note, all examples show the fouled player's color as yellow. The cue ball has a straight line path to the yellow ball between the two red balls. This situation is not a total snooker to the player on yellows. The cue ball has no straight line path to the yellow ball. It would hit one or other of the red balls before it reached the yellow ball. This situation is a total snooker to the player on yellows. The cue ball has a straight line path to the yellow ball between the two red balls. Even though you can only see a thin edge of the yellow ball, you can still hit it. This situation is not a total snooker to the player on yellows. The cushions are taken into account when deciding if a total snooker exists, unlike for foul snookers. Although the cue ball has a path between the red balls to hit the yellow ball, it would hit the cushion before the yellow ball and would have to bounce to make contact with the yellow ball, so is not a straight line path. This situation is a total snooker to the player on yellows. Foul snookers and foul jaw snookers. If your opponent has fouled and left you in a situation where you cannot play the finest cut possible on both sides of at least one of your balls, by way of a straight line shot, then you are either foul snookered or foul jaw snookered. Note, all examples show the fouled player's color as yellow. The right-hand red ball is stopping you from making the finest cut possible on the right-hand side of the yellow ball. This situation is a foul snooker to the player on yellows. The closer the cue ball is to the object ball, the closer together the finest cuts possible become. The right-hand red ball is stopping from making the finest cut possible on the right-hand side of the yellow ball. This situation is a foul snooker to the player on yellows. You cannot be snookered on an object ball if the cue ball is touching that object ball. When the cue ball is touching the object ball, both finest cuts possible are effectively in the same place as where the balls are touching. As the cue ball is touching the yellow ball, this counts as having hit the yellow ball when a shot is played. You can play a legal shot away from the yellow ball in any direction. This situation is not a foul snooker to the player on yellows. You cannot be snookered by a ball of your own color. If you remove the offending yellow ball, it is possible to play the finest cut possible on both sides of the other yellow ball. This situation is not a foul snooker to the player on yellows. The cushions are ignored when deciding if a foul snooker exists. You could play both finest cuts possible on the yellow ball if the cushion was not there. This situation is not a foul snooker to the player on yellows. Even though the cushions are ignored when deciding if a foul snooker exists, the right-hand red ball is stopping you making the finest cut possible on the right-hand side of the yellow ball, even if the cushion was not present. This situation is a foul snooker to the player on yellows. Although the yellow ball can be seen clearly, the red ball would be contacted before you could make the finest cut possible on the right side of the yellow ball. This situation is a foul snooker to the player on yellows. The jaw of the pocket is preventing you from making the finest cut possible on the left side of the yellow ball. This situation is a foul jaw snooker to the player on yellows and only exists when the cue ball is in the jaws of the pocket, not the object ball.